This is where our story begins, here at the Fangoria Weekend of Horrors convention, where legendary scaremeister Harry Penderecki will be making an appearance to announce production of his latest picture, Brutal Massacre. We've been invited to ride shotgun alongside Harry to document what is sure to be a landmark horror film.
Yeah!
Yeah.
Next is the creator of Masters of Horror. He's worked with Stephen King more than anyone else. Let's hear it for Mick Garris! And last but not least, he's been out of the scene for a while, but he's back better than ever. This is the man who gave us such cult classics as The Mummy's Daddy, P is for Pain, and that taut thriller, The Unforgettable, I'll Take the Ring Back, and The Finger Too. Let's hear it for Harry Penderecki.
Yeah! Yeah, fuck yeah! Yeah! Yeah, fuck yeah!
Okay, let's open it up to some questions.
Mr. Penderecki.
Yes.
Can you tell us what inspires you to make such graphically violent films?
Well, my films are simply a reaction to the world around me. I take what I see and filter it with my own personal opinions and perspective, and what comes out is a creative response to my environment.
And what in your immediate environment would you say is the primary influence for your film Bowel Movement, where your victims are forced to eat gunpowder and then blow themselves up when they defecate?
Well, I know what you're getting at, and let me just say that my films serve as a safe outlet for the pent-up aggression that festers in all of us. Yes.
Yes, question for Mr. Penderecki. Do you feel at all responsible for the death of Oscar Phelps, the young boy who was killed while imitating a stunt from your film, Teasing a Gorilla?
You know, during the mid-80s, there was an experiment done in a Midwestern town where they removed all forms of pornography from all the local shelves for a period of 1 year. Now, during the course of that year, violent crime, including rape, went up 200%, thus proving that restricting people from a safe and healthy outlet for their emotions is far worse than satisfying it.
In your life did you decide you wanted to become a filmmaker?
Well, when I was a kid, nobody thought I'd amount to anything. Back in high school, I was voted most likely to disappoint my parents. It was then that I decided that, well, I was going to be somebody.
Have you ever thought about branching out into another genre, like drama or maybe comedy?
Well, I've built up an audience of hardcore fans over the years. I think that they would feel betrayed if I deviated from what made me successful.
Your last three films haven't achieved the box office of your previous work. Do you feel these failures have affected your marketability as a writer or director?
No. My last film, Garbage Man, was a bomb in the States, but was a huge hit overseas. In fact, the theme song went to number 3 in the charts in Germany.
Is that right?
Yeah. You want to hear it?
Sure. You went through some litigation over Garbage Man.
That's correct.
A stunt person was crushed during filming?
I was absolved of any wrongdoing.
Going up.
Barry.
Larry.
Harry.
Harry had a minor hit with us a few years back called Retirement Home. It's about a nasty orderly who would go around giving the retired residents heart attacks by dressing up as the Grim Reaper and jumping out of their closets at them. So when he called me and told me he had a new idea, I thought, why not? So I told him to come over.
Have a seat.
Thanks.
So what have you got for me?
It's a horror movie.
We're not looking for any horror right now.
But the horror genre is hotter than ever.
I'm sorry.
No, please, this isn't your average run-of-the-mill cliche horror film. Just give me a minute.
Okay, what's the title?
Brutal Massacre.
Harry Penderecki to see Mr. Shank Smith.
1 minute.
Is it always a last-minute rush to secure funding for your projects?
No, we had funding, but the investors pulled out at the last minute.
Did they give a reason?
Everything was going fine until they insisted on reading the script. Might have been a blessing in disguise, though. They were real control freaks. They had their hands all over everything.
Except the script.
Oh, hi. It's nothing worse than some dick trying to tell you how to make your movie.
Needs more titties.
Excuse me?
Titties, son. Can't make a horror movie without titties. That's the whole point. You show the titties so that when the fucker is cutting her up, the audience thinks, oh man, he's cutting up them fine ooters.
This film is different.
Why, is it for queers?
Well, no, I just don't think there's any room for graphic nudity. It's a real story here. Deep character developments. And the situation they're in, it would seem really unlikely for them to just suddenly disrobe.
Look, you making this for yourself or for an audience? You know, you can't sell these fright films if there's no nakedness. I only invest in a sure thing.
I don't know.
If you want my participation, you're gonna have to work with me on this.
Well, thank you. I can't.
Look, you're lucky you're even in here. Your last three films combined didn't earn enough to pay back the catering tab. Just because you made one big hit, don't mean boo shit. This town has a very short memory, son.
Would you be willing to take your top off on film?
What?
It's a simple question, honey. Would you be willing to get naked in front of the camera?
There's nothing in the script that suggests anything about nudity.
Well, this is Hollywood, honey. Things change here in a heartbeat.
This is bullshit.
Yeah, I'll see you on the unemployment line.
Next.
Name, age, last film you worked on.
Sally Johnson, 24. This would be my first feature film.
Well, good luck. I'm gonna read with you today, and before we begin, I want you to know there's nudity in this film. Are you okay with taking your top off?
Sure!
Oh, yeah!
Oh, no, honey. No. On the set. Put your top back on. Keep it in your pants, you degenerate. Where's my coffee?
This is it for Harry. This is his last chance. You know, three strikes and you're out, and believe me, he's already had his three, so I guess. Well, the last one did okay in Japan. I mean, but, you know, if you don't understand the language, it's hard to tell if the acting is bad, right? So that was a push. And I agreed to come onto the project because, well, we go way back. He's a nice guy. When his blood sugar's not off the wall.
What would you say are your influences as a director?
So many directors you talk to try to make themselves seem intelligent by bragging about them being influenced by the really obscure artsy-fartsy directors, you know, like Fellini, Eisenstein, Bergman, Reitman. I don't try to put on such pretentious airs. What you see is what you get. I think I'm most influenced by my fans. And Jojo Van Buren, but you never heard of him.
I'm not familiar with this one.
Well, this had a very short run. It's one of my more graphic films. A real underground following. The screenplay was inspired by The Beatles' Abbey Road.
Ah, The Fish Who Ate Flesh broke all box office records in South America.
The Fish Who Ate Flesh was very unique because they can relate to that sort of thing down there. They lose more people to man-eating piranha than we do car accidents.
Was that a difficult shoot?
Oh, we used mostly stock footage, so I just filled in the blanks.
The reviews weren't that forgiving.
Well, I only read bad reviews. Yeah, any criticism is productive. It serves to, make you grow as an artist. Positive reviews only serve to inflate the ego.
Do they affect you that way?
I'm sure they would.
This next one's a little different, but I think with your art wizard, you could make it work. I can tell you don't like it.
It's a gas station.
Well, with a little imagination.
It's supposed to look like the house of a deranged killer.
So you don't want me to take some pictures?
ADing Harry's movies for about 10 years now. And we met, well, I started out in children's shows, you know, public broadcasting.
Hey, kids! You know what time it is?
Harry approached me with this idea of a slasher film for kids. It was called Killer Koala. But it didn't take off. I mean, the idea looked great on paper. I mean, it had moral themes. Like, the kids who ate their vegetables and did their homework, they were spared. The kids who didn't, well, anyway. But nobody wanted to distribute it. Harry, he tried to spin it into a morning cartoon, but, well, anyway. We've been working together ever since.
Please, Harry, my friends are still out there. Please hurry. My friends are still out there. Please hurry. My friends are still out there. Please hurry.
How's it going?
Oh, my brain.
Ho Jung?
She read the part well. She's really talented.
Gladys, this film takes place in middle America. No one's gonna buy her as a typical God-fearing, corn-fed teenager.
Are you saying there are no Oriental women in Middle America?
Has anybody seen my bag? Mr. Penderecki.
Yes?
Can I have your autograph?
Really?
I mean, people have actually seen your movies.
What's your name?
Mandy.
Mandy.
You know, I have to tell you, People Past Aside changed my life.
Really?
It's what made me want to get into acting.
Is that so?
Sure, I figured if that girl can do it, anyone can.
Have you read for the role of Lola?
I did, but I don't think it went very well.
Oh, I think you'd be perfect for the role.
You do?
I don't think I even have to see you audition.
Oh my God, that would be so amazing. I would give anything to work with you.
Absolutely. You're a natural.
What the fuck are you doing?
Sorry, I
damn right, asshole! Jerk!
Smooth.
So what's it about?
It's a thriller.
Thriller, huh?
It's a balls-out horror film.
Balls out?
Yeah, none of that cliche crap.
It's a little over the top, but nothing extraordinary.
Well, I'm a church-going man. Don't know if I'd feel comfortable allowing you to shoot a horror film on my property. You know, on account of my religious beliefs.
Well, it's not your typical gory exploitation film. It's got a story and shit. It's a real, sophisticated.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, what's it called?
Brutal Massacre.
What do you mean you weren't sure this was gonna happen? London? What the fuck's in London? What is it, some sort of fucking art house film? What's it called? Oh, great. Oh, yeah. Rose of Forgiveness. Great. Listen, doesn't your closet have enough crap?
I met Harry on the set of Look Out, which was a thriller about a serial killer who's an expert at throwing knives.
I never heard of that one.
Well, as the story progresses, we find out he's escaped from a circus prison, which was an experimental project where they reform prisoners by turning them into circus act performers. Anyway, the experiment is a complete disaster, and they end up closing the project down. It's based on a true story.
And you two have worked together on every project since.
Yeah. You know, a lot of directors come and go. Most lesser directors would have eaten a bullet by now.
Too determined.
Too chicken. He's too scared to blow his brains out.
I found an old review of the film, The Fish Who Ate Flesh, that appeared in the New York Times. This film makes me wish that Thomas Edison had been a shoemaker. No stars, minus a star if you have 20/20 vision.
He obviously was a frustrated filmmaker.
Here's another one I found from your film, The Untrained Surgeon. The Untrained Surgeon could be the first film that provides legitimate grounds for suing for your 2 hours back.
Obviously didn't grasp the subtext of the film.
You also had a stuntman die during production of that film.
That's correct.
In fact, you've had some sort of tragedy mark virtually every film you've made. Have you noticed any backlash in the industry with regard to these consistent mishaps? Are some people afraid to work with you?
You get the occasional fruitcake who insists on you doing things like hiring a stunt coordinator, but for the most part, people realize that shit happens. I try to surround myself with good people, but I've been the victim of some bad karma. But you can't let the evil spirits win.
Laughing in the face of adversity?
I really don't think it's funny.
I meant it as a compliment.
Look, it's a known fact that a lot of your blockbuster films have suffered through some difficult shoots. Jaws, Star Wars, Cannonball Run. There were no walk in the park. Take a film like Apocalypse Now. Great film. But do you think that was a walk in the park? No way. You ask Scorsese, he'll tell you.
This is it. This is the house. Does anyone live here?
I can find out.
Nope.
Are you the owner?
Fucking A.
Oh, we're from LMB Productions. We're scouting locations for a film.
What kind of film?
A horror film.
Oh, nice. Need a killer? Because I was in fucking Vietnam.
You're the owner of this place?
In the flesh, toots.
Would you consider allowing the production to film here? I can guarantee that we will make safe use of the premises.
I don't give a fuck. Do whatever the fuck you want. Shit, I'm just gonna tear the fucker down next spring and rebuild it.
Oh, so we could, like, age the walls and paint?
Knock the fucking walls down. I don't give a fuck.
Awesome. We can't afford to pay you much.
How much you got?
$500?
Shit, do whatever you want, fucker.
I'll go get the paperwork.
Want a beer?
Oh, shit, yeah. Thanks, man.
Want a beer, sexy?
No, thanks.
Hey, can I check it out?
I don't give a fuck.
You did? Hey, that's great. Where is it? Yeah, anything we want, huh? Yeah, what's the catch? Okay, well, just get it in writing. Now, you sure he's the owner? No, Jay, I'm not saying you're stupid. Okay, all right, great. Good work. Yeah, can't wait to see the pictures.
I remember when it first came out, I went to see it over and over. I guess it was the title that got me. I'll Take the Ring Back and the Finger Too. Man, what a movie! They don't make them like that no more. I can still hear my wife say it. You gonna see that damn movie again? What about your job? Fucking bitch.
Felipe?
Jay?
What's going?
Bought my album. Figured since this would be our first time working together.
Oh, great. Nice. Yeah, you got the specs, right?
Piece of cake. Dead bodies are my specialty.
Now, it's very important that the body looks real. I mean, it has to convey realism. Otherwise, it could compromise the whole scene. I mean, the whole movie.
If the cops found it in your car, you'd be arrested and charged with murder.
Awesome. Awesome!
Ooh. Hey.
Wee!
What do you think?
What do I think? I think you've lost your fucking mind. Our budget can't afford this.
Sure it can.
You have absolutely no concept of money, do you?
Well, I just wanted to treat us all for a change. We're always roughing it.
Oh, treat us all, huh? Oh, look, a jacuzzi tub. Funny, my room doesn't have a fucking jacuzzi tub.
You play Lola in the film?
I am Lola.
So you take this part very seriously.
I believe all film is art. I feel if Picasso were alive today, he'd throw away his airbrush and pick up a camera.
How would you describe your character in the film?
Lola is searching for a deeper meaning to her life. She goes on this journey with Psycho Alan, the accountant who goes insane and joins the biker gang. She sees his transformation as a metaphor for the lies in the world.
She feels she's been lied to?
You're not listening.
Sorry.
This film represents a common truth that runs through all parts of life in the world. That truth is, there's no pure good. Even the most noble of gestures are tainted with some sort of self-serving philanthropy. Whereas there is definitely pure evil in the world, we see it every day. So it reveals this common truth that evil is the only truly pure emotion.
So you're saying no one is purely good, but there are people who are purely evil.
Exactly.
That's very depressing.
Now you're paying attention. Lola's struggle reflects her inability to accept this truth that she has a dark side too. And the killer's inner turmoil is a metaphor for the evil which is prevalent everywhere in today's society.
You seem to be very well read on the subject.
I read the entire script.
You play the part of Amanda. Is this your first starring role?
I was in Bitch Slapped. I was the bitch who did the slapping. Hand me that shirt.
Sure. What was it that you liked about Harry's film?
What are you, like a fucking idiot? The film's like not even made yet.
No. What made you want to appear in a Harry Penderecki movie?
Whose movie?
Describe Amanda's character arc in the film.
She gets cut in half with a machete.
Sorry.
You look tired. Did you get any sleep?
I've never been a very good sleeper. I have an innate fear of dying in my sleep. I generally just toss and turn until I eventually pass out from exhaustion.
I love the first day. Everyone's feeling each other out. There's a nervous tension in the air.
The excitement and anxiety level is probably on par with a heavyweight boxer the night of a big fight.
Making an independent film and competing with Hollywood is like taking a beautiful woman to an expensive restaurant with only about $6 in your pocket. And you know you've got to impress her, and you're trying to figure out how to pay for all this. That doesn't make any sense at all. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about.
It's still early.
I have worked with Harry long years. Many movies. Lots of fun, lots not fun. Like brothers. And Harry called me a few weeks ago and asked me get on board on a movie he's doing right now, Brutal Massacre. I've never read the script, but Harry told me, Hanu, this is it.
Hanu's the best. I met him while shooting a film in India, Chicken Tikka Massacre. We hit it off right away. It's almost like he knows what I'm thinking. He's always thinking about the shot, always framing. He's also a decorated veteran of the Indian Army, a real tough guy. I once saw him take down a man 6'5". Hanu's only 5'5", so that's well over a foot taller.
Welcome, everyone, to the commencement of principal photography of Brutal Massacre. First off, I'd like to apologize in advance for the cold coffee and stale donuts. Unfortunately, we are miles from civilization, and certain sacrifices are to be expected.
Oh, and also, just as a warning, it is hunting season in these woods, and we are right on the border, so please, nobody wander off set.
Dick. Now, I'd like everyone to join me in a moment of silent prayer to the film gods so that they may bestow upon us success and also for the safety and well-being of both our cast and crew.
Fucking mercenaries.
Hold on a second. Hold on a second. Slow down. Take it from the beginning.
There's a killer out there. You've got to hurry.
Are you telling me there's a killer out there?
Yes!
Has he killed anyone?
Yes! Please hurry, my friends are still out there!
What are you saying?
Cut! Oscar, that line needs more intensity. You are generally concerned for the kids out there. Let the audience share that.
Okay, boss.
Okay, let's take it from Amy's last line.
Okay, we're still rolling. Lock it up, people. Quiet.
And action!
Please hurry, my friends are still out there!
What are you saying?
Cut! Oscar, are you telling the audience that you're concerned or that you need a hearing aid?
Got it. Sorry.
More excitement, more intensity.
Intensity. Gotcha.
Great.
Harry, I cannot work with this ape.
You look great, huh? Stomach in, chest out, you're exhausted. Let the audience see those heaving breaths.
Heaving what?
Action!
Please hurry! My friends are still out there!
What are you saying?
Cut!
Hey!
Oh. Hi. I'm Andy. I'm with the film production company. So, you sure it's okay for me to do whatever I want to the house?
Oh, I don't give a fuck. Fuck, shit. Do whatever you want, fucker. I'm just gonna tear the motherfucker down and rebuild it. Go, do your worst. Tear the whole fucking shit house down. Want a beer?
No, thanks.
Why, you queer?
What? Gay people don't drink?
I was in the Nam, pussy fart. I'll twist your head off and go bowling. You know, there were some kids killed for real in these woods. Fucking A. Never caught the motherfucker neither.
Do I look like craft services? That's over there.
Jay, it's Andy.
Andy? Yeah, go for Jay. What? No. That's Crenshaw. He's the owner of the house. Andy? No, he's not gonna kill you. He's just drunk. Stop being such a fucking pussy and do your job, dude. Look, where else are we going to get a house like that?
It has to be breakaway, otherwise it won't come off when the killer grabs it.
Yeah, but of course it has to be one of the coldest days, right?
Okay, ready?
Yeah.
Okay, let's just hope they get it all in one take, because I don't know how the fabric will hold up.
Oh, yeah!
Fuck off, creepo! Maricón, hijo la gran puta, cabrón!
Hey, Mike, what are you doing, man? There's dry hay all over this place. You trying to kill us? Okay, people, pictures up. Roll sounds.
Speed.
And action. And cut.
That's great, let's move on. Oh, whoa, but the dress malfunctioned. It didn't rip off.
No, but it looked great. See her face?
I'm sorry.
What happened to the titties, man?
My dress staying on is a malfunction. My agent's so fired.
Hey, Felipe, how's that prop coming along?
It's almost done.
Okay, is there anything we can see?
Hey, pendejo! I'm an artist. It's done when it's done. Nobody goes in there. Nobody.
How do you say your last name?
Vindapesh.
Hanu Vindapesh. What's that, Italian? Just kidding.
Repeat after me. I'm a fucking asshole.
I think we lost him.
I think you're right.
We gotta keep moving and try and get help.
It's the rush, baby.
There's a killer out there?
No one's gonna find us out here. Besides, hearing you scream kinda made me horny.
Wait a minute. Where were you when Jeremy was killed? How do I know you're not the killer?
Fuck you!
Cut! Everyone back to one. Guys, let's take it from the top. That was good. Roll sound.
Speed.
And action.
I think we lost him.
I think you're right.
We've got to keep moving and try and get help.
What's the rush, baby?
There's a killer out there?
No one's gonna find us out here. Besides, hearing you scream kinda made me horny.
Wait a minute. Where were you when Jeremy was killed? How do I know you're not the killer?
Quiet, motherfucker! God damn it!
Man.
We're gonna need security on this set.
For as long as I can remember, I've been plagued by evil spirits. It's why I direct horror films. It's my way of purging myself from the evil demons.
Have you given any thought to the fact that this may be a self-fulfilling prophecy? That perhaps the very act of making these horror films invites these malevolent demons in and gives them a comfortable home in which to dwell?
Here's to the first week down, huh?
Yeah. Hooray! Yeah.
Cheers, cheers, everyone!
Sue me. Sue me for what?
Oh. The fuck you gawking at?
Firefighters said that when they arrived, the house was there.
Hey, Harry, take a look!
Yeah, we shot this in Europe. Over there, they call this El Libro del Muertos.
The Reading Dead?
Not even bullets work against this strain. The only thing that'll stop them is a book, anything printed. They're forced to read every word, kind of like a vampire that has to count the grains of sand poured over a coffin.
That's ridiculous. I'll bet she's glad she has a library card.
Harry?
Yes?
Okay. Let's say I agree to do the shot.
What shot?
You know?
Oh, that shot.
Yeah, well, if I decide to do it, which I haven't yet, could you do it in just one take?
I can't guarantee that. You know how it is.
Look, I'll do it.
but only if you can get it on the first take. You get one shot after that, too bad.
Well, listen, it's not me. It's the investors are pushing for that scene.
You know, the stars get all the glitter. Bad kids, 14-hour days, bad food. After a while, you know, it begins to wear on you. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't mind getting home at 5, having my weekends for myself.
One time, I don't know how to say this, but one time we were shooting, going 16 hours straight, no breaks, and I crapped in my pants. Everybody started laughing. You know, everybody except Harry, who was so behind schedule, man, but he stopped the shoot. And he took me to the side and got me a new pair of pants. And Harry, he didn't say nothing. Nothing.
Harry, you get one take at this shot, and this is it.
Right, one. Honey, I need to get this in one, okay?
Don't tell me that. That's their problem, not mine.
Okay, roll sound.
Speed.
And action. Cut. Great. Hanu, we good? Okay, call it.
Okay, that's the day, people. Call time tomorrow, 8:30 a.m.
Very nice.
The killer's been here.
How can you tell?
All of these dead bodies.
What happened?
I don't know, man. The sound was synced at the lab. Let's watch another take. Huh?
The killer's been here.
How can you tell?
All of these dead
Oh, shit.
I'd talk to your sound guy.
Has anyone seen Mike?
People just don't die with one stab. They fight to stay alive. You got to stab them over and over.
20, 30 times.
You'd be amazed how much blood is in the human body.
Hey. I just talked to the lab. They said there's nothing on the tape that matches the film's time code for those scenes. Do you remember having any problem?
Well, to be honest, there might have been something.
Might?
Yeah, I don't usually work with that. I use a Nagra, so I'm not really hip to all that error message lingo.
Error message?
Yeah, maybe some sort of SMPTE time code error.
SMPTE error?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
What mean?
Maybe some kind of error?
Maybe some kind of error.
Look, just because I don't know what it means doesn't mean I'm lying.
How many other films have you worked on besides this one?
Other films?
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit.
Hey, what's the big deal?
Do you know how much you cost us on reshoots?
No, how much?
Thousands of dollars, that's how much.
Okay, look, why do you gotta reshoot? Why don't you just loop it with ADR?
I don't like dubbing, it doesn't look right.
Look, it's not like there was that much dialogue in the scene to begin with anyway.
Okay. Just the stress of this shoot, I'm fine.
So you think this is gonna affect the morale of the production? You think you'll rebound from this?
Well, I have to remain optimistic. As the director, I have to project a positive attitude at all times.
This is a man's world, but it would be nothing, nothing without a woman's love.
Carl,
what's
going on with this dolly track, man?
Waiting on the Marlboro man.
Oh, hey, Mike, every time I'm looking at you, you're on a friggin' cigarette break. You're not being paid to smoke.
You're not paying me at all.
Put it out and get going.
What happened? Well, I thought he was the killer.
So you shot him?
What was I supposed to do, huh? You ever hear of due process? The judicial system? There's no law out here. There's just survival. We got an even bigger problem. We still got a killer out there with a knife about this big.
Cut! Can we help you?
What are you doing here?
What's it look like we're doing? We're shooting a movie.
Oh, really?
Look, lady, this is a close set. I'm gonna have to ask you to leave.
But I have to tell you something important.
Hey, come on!
Come on,
hey,
man! Come on.
Look, they're calling me back to set. I really gotta go.
Wait!
Okay, places, everyone. Roll sound!
Speed.
And action.
What happened? I thought he was the killer. So you shot him?
Well, what was I supposed to do, huh?
You ever hear of due process? The judicial system?
There's no law out here.
Cut! Who the hell is that?
Who the hell is that?
Some nosy woman. I told her to leave. Hang on. Look, lady, I told you this is a closed set. You're costing us money. You'll have to leave.
But I have to tell you something important.
I'm sorry. It'll have to wait. We're very, very busy.
But what I have to tell you is very important.
Too bad.
Please, 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 baby, please, don't.
Cut the fuck up!
Okay, sorry about that. Okay, everybody, back to one. Okay, are we ready now?
Yeah. Roll sound.
Speed.
Action.
What happened?
Well, I thought he was the killer.
So you shot him? What was I supposed to do, huh? You ever hear of due process? The judicial system?
There's no law out here. It's just survival.
Cut! Somebody get me a gun!
Shit! This is it! I told you to get lost! What do you have, Anheuser's?
I just need to tell you something!
What? What?
I need to tell you all! You're too close to the shooting range! It's right on the other side of those trees!
Oh, shit. Run! Run! Shit!
I don't know. I got a bad feeling about this one. I mean, I know you always joke about some evil presence hanging over you.
That's no joke.
But I actually feel like there is some sort of angry specter hanging over this production.
That's because this is the one, the big one, don't you see? The evil knows I'm gonna win this time.
Listen to yourself.
What?
I'm worried about you.
You are?
Yeah. I actually think you're starting to believe your own bullshit.
Arthur.
Harry.
How you doing?
Good, good. What a surprise.
Sit down and join us.
I can't. I've got my driver waiting outside.
Always first class. Hey, what brings you out here?
Actually, we just wrapped on a pitch I'm doing about the Civil War.
Oh, I read about that. Some big names.
Yes, yes. And, well, how about you? Are you still running around to all of those horror movie conventions?
You're looking good.
Yes. You know, my wife has me on a new regimen of seafood and fine wine. It's delivered to the house every morning, ready to eat. She's into that kind of thing. She would be pissed off if she knew I was eating at a place like this.
You still out on the West Coast?
Yes, part of the year, yes. You know, well, it was very nice seeing you both. Natalie.
Arthur.
You know, you always have been a glutton for punishment, haven't you? Take my card. Call me. I can always use a good production person.
Don't let him get to you.
I'm not. I wouldn't. It's just, you know, what are you doing?
Anything else?
Sure. How about your phone number?
Have a nice night, sir.
Well, what about the phone number?
I hardly know you.
But that's the idea. You give me the number, and we get to know each other. Well, fuck you then.
Oh my God! What happened?
did this to you?
The killer.
Are you sure?
Oh, Kat!
There's no lore out here. There's just survival. You got an even bigger problem. You still got a killer out there. With a knife. About this big.
Who the fuck is this guy?
Well, that's Oscar Brody. He's good. He's a classically trained character actor.
Couldn't you get somebody good like a Christopher Walken? Or that guy, what the heck's his name? He was in that movie, he plays a stupid guy. Dump.
Gump.
Yeah, Gump.
Tom Hanks?
Yeah?
His schedule was booked.
Well, you give me and the boys a few minutes, we'll free up his schedule. Know what I mean?
That won't be necessary.
Stan Lee. Any relation to the comic book author?
No. And when you credit me, it's Stanley. One word.
You consolidated Stan Lee into Stanley.
It's easier. Like Madonna. Or Mako.
You seem to have quite an entourage for someone who really hasn't hit the big time yet.
Fortunately, my father just passed away, leaving behind a significant share of Microsoft stock. So I'm really just in it for the fun.
How would you rate your experience with Harry as compared to the other directors you've worked with in the past?
He's an idiot. I could point out a number of glaring flaws in the script, particularly with my character. I mean, anyone that has that much trouble raising money and putting together a project, well, he's politely being told something.
And that is?
Some things are better left on the page.
Does this mean you'll ever work with him again?
When you're dealing with directors of this level, they're all morons. I mean, if you want to cruise through college, you've got one of two options. It's either liberal arts or film. I actually feel bad for these guys. I mean, I'm just in it for the fun. These losers actually have to make a living hawking this shit. Especially Harry. I mean, take a hint, mate. You've got no talent. He's stupid, whore!
What? It's not like it's a toaster or nothing.
Excellent!
The head was only partially loaded. Once fully loaded, you'll see it gush profusely.
Oh, excellent. Now, what about our dead corpse?
Is there any other kind?
Ha ha.
It's almost done. A few more finishing touches.
Oh, awesome. Now look, do a fucking great job, because the whole ending is riding on the authenticity of that prop. I mean, that has to, has to be awesome.
Trust me, after we wrap,
you'll feel obligated to give it a proper burial.
Awesome.
Awesome!
Jay. Where did you find this guy?
Oh.
Never mind. Just make sure the dead body was never living. You know what I mean? You remember Bulgaria?
Oh, no. He's okay.
Did Natalie check him out?
I checked him out.
Okay.
We're scraping the barrel here. I don't see how we can continue without making some major cutbacks.
Well, who's expendable at this point?
How about Jay?
Oh, come on. Give him a break.
Well, Alyssa can double as props and wardrobe. But some of the grips are gonna have to go.
I've got a movie to shoot.
Maybe you should have thought of that before you rented that fancy hotel. Look, I'm sure you're aware of how things have been going on this shoot.
I'm not gonna beat around the bush. I need to let some people go.
Is that right? Who are you thinking of?
I know you've been really dedicated.
Oh, fucking way! I'm fired?
Nothing personal.
God damn it! This happens to me on every set I work on!
Damn, cheap-ass equipment.
Hey, Carl.
Hey, how are we doing with those lights?
About 10 more minutes.
Great. Listen, we had to let Mike go.
That's too bad.
Yeah, so I'm gonna need you to help out a little more from here on in. Are you okay with that?
Hey, Harry, I'm a team player.
Great.
So listen, you let me know if you need anything. You know, I got two hands, too.
All right. Just lay it down right there. Hey, Harry. Thanks for keeping me around. You know this is gonna be my last film shoot?
Really?
Yeah, that's right. I've been taking computer classes and I got a job waiting for me in Virginia.
Wow. Well, that's great, Carl. Good for you.
Yeah. No more lugging around hot lights 14 hours a day.
Well, good luck.
Yeah. Thanks, G.
I'm writing a movie now. It's kind of cool. It's a horror film. Surprise, surprise. It's about like the original people of the Amazon. You know how the rainforest is like shrinking, and there's not enough going around. So the Amazon people who live there, are like, what the fuck? You're ruining my world. And it's like if humans were just all living on one island, and the island was shrinking because of water, they'd fight it back. So the original Amazon people, what they're gonna do is they're gonna train nature to do their bidding. So they're gonna make like piranhas and anacondas like to kill like the workers who are like logging and farming and stuff. And they're gonna have the trees, they're gonna inject trees with to extrude poisonous sap. So like when logging machines come down, like the sap drips and like burns them away. It's fucking awesome.
But you can't leave. There's still two more weeks of shooting.
You didn't mention any fucking snow. I don't like the cold.
Oh, we have a problem.
What?
Tanya is squeamish about the blood scene.
Squeamish?
Yeah, she doesn't want to do the scene.
Are you kidding me? What is she, 12?
Look, I tried talking to her. She just doesn't want to do the scene.
This might be a good thing. Yeah, this might actually help her performance.
Oh, yeah.
Tell her that we cleaned the room, she can walk through and scream, and we'll put the blood in later with computer effects.
Computer? Dude, all I have is Nintendo.
No, dummy, you just tell her that. Keep the room as is, and keep the door closed until she enters.
Oh, I got it. That's a great idea.
I get one, every now and then.
Sure. Like shooting in the fucking snow.
Hey.
Hey.
We have a solution. We're gonna use computer effects.
You expect me to believe that you guys don't even have working toilets? Look, I realize the scene is important and everything, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do it.
Well, that could help your performance.
You think?
Trust me, real fear looks even more real on camera.
Yeah, you're right. We could go ahead and do it.
All right. And just remember, it's only Karo syrup and cornstarch.
Well, that's not that scary. Thanks, Jay.
What?
Cut.
What the hell was that?
Don't tell me that shot's out of focus.
It's out of focus.
God damn it! Now what do I do?
Ask her to do it again.
She won't. She said one take only. I agreed.
I thought Hanu said it was good.
He did. He held up his fucking finger and everything. Fucker!
Bring it back. Play it again.
Oh, man, that's out of focus.
Fuck! You said this was good. You said good.
This don't mean good. This mean one more take.
I thought it meant you're number one.
No,
But you always do the finger like I'm the best.
The finger means one more take.
Since when?
Since forever.
What means good?
Fuck.
Dude, I hope you're calling unemployment because you're gonna be out of a job. Get off the fucking phone. All right, put those cones behind the RV. Make sure no one gets through. Yeah. Why are you taking my picture? I'm not in the fucking movie. Come on, knock it off. Dude, what are you doing? What, we're gonna sit in the middle of the road? Wake the fuck up, over near the RV. Come on! What is this, your first day? I don't see no fucking camera on the car. Let's move it, will ya?
Fucking dick.
Listen, people, I got 4 hours to get 15 fucking shots. So please, wake up and let's move it!
No. They're supposed to direct traffic from West Street. We're on West Street.
Hey, Natalie.
Not now. Just get back to me right away.
It's kind of important.
What?
The RV's toilet is full.
And what would you like me to do about it?
Well, I don't really care. You know me, I'm a team player, but some of the others are complaining.
It's gonna be one of those days, right?
Well, can't we get a PA to go find a campsite somewhere and empty it? I mean, there must be 100 campsites around here.
We have one PA left, and he's doing everything else. I'm gonna have to do it myself.
You're gonna drive that?
Yes.
Good luck.
Harry,
let's do this.
We got a problem.
Why don't you tell me when you don't have a problem? We'll save some time.
We don't have any bills for the money stack.
What?
The stack of money for the bribery scene?
Huh?
We have the 100 for the top of the stack, but we need like 200 singles to make the middle of the stack look real.
Don't you have any money?
Oh. Do you?
Are you from around here?
Yeah, man, born and raised.
Did Natalie hire you? What's your name?
Lewis.
Here, here's $200. I want you to get 200 singles from the nearest bank.
All right.
Quick as you can.
Cool.
Do you have a car?
No, man.
Jay, give him the keys to the van.
To the rental?
Yeah. Quick as you can.
Far out.
Where the hell is he?
See anything?
No. Wait, I see something!
Fuck you, camel fuckers!
What happened?
I quit.
What?
I quit!
Are you okay?
I never want you to call me again. Don't ever speak to me again.
Now look, just calm down and tell me what happened.
What does it look like?
yet.
I'm leaving now. I never, ever, ever want to speak to you again.
Look, just will you calm down? Why not go back to the hotel, take a shower, and we'll talk about this later.
No, no talking, because I'm covered in shit. I quit.
That dude ain't coming back.
God, what smells like ass? Ooh, what happened to you?
Don't.
He's not coming back.
Of course he's coming back.
Who?
Harry gave a PA 200s to go to the bank to get singles for the bribery scene.
What PA?
Lewis.
You don't have a fucking PA named Lewis.
But I thought you hired... You said...
Dude, we just got fucking robbed.
God, you stink!
What are you doing?
What's it look like?
Oh, come on, Nat. You're not gonna bail on me over something like this.
Face it, Harry. It's over. This film has been a disaster since the beginning.
Hey, shit happens. I'm sorry.
I cannot clean up your messes anymore.
You think that's what I'm worried about?
Well, what then?
I need you here.
You need to get a day job.
Well, you know I could never do that.
We all have to go through it sometime.
Go through what?
Life's little reality check. You're living in this fantasy world.
You're actually leaving?
You had your shot, Harry. You had your day in the sun. I don't think lightning's gonna strike twice for you.
Are these men's?
I'm tired of waiting for you to grow up.
Natalie.
Take care of yourself, Harry.
Come on, Nat.
Natalie. Hey, Natalie. What do you mean you've waited?
Ah, let her go. She's of no use to us now.
What?
Time and space have no meaning.
on Harry. Harry! Oh.
Felipe says that the prop is ready.
What prop?
The prop?
Oh, finally.
And the rental company called. That guy crashed the van. They said that since we didn't have insurance on the van, that we're obligated for all the damages.
How bad's the crash?
It was totaled.
Oh, call Natalie. Oh, shit.
I'll do it.
Hey, let's see what you got, man.
You ready? Well, what you think?
Is this a joke?
This is a work of art! Come on, tell him! Best $1,000 you ever spent, right? Once you light it right, it'll be awesome, man!
You fucked us, dude!
You don't like it?
Ah! Oh! Harry!
Harry! You can't say! You guys are crazy!
Harry, no! Harry! Harry, don't! Wait!
You guys are crazy!
Harry, no! Harry!
Now what the hell are we supposed to do? We gotta think about this rationally. We still need a corpse.
And cut! Good. Now let's get a shot of the knife impaling in the wall. Now I want the light gleaming off that knife.
Carl, adjust the bounce board.
Got it.
Now, remember to dive out of the way before the killer throws the knife.
Harry, is that a real knife?
Just try to look dead. This is humiliating.
Okay, quiet please.
Carl, you're in the way there. The knife's gonna be a projectile.
Where should I go?
Anywhere but there.
I'll go back here.
Joey, hurry up, please. This rope is choking me.
Will you stop moving? It won't match. I think your tongue was hanging to the left. Okay, everyone. Quiet, please. Roll sound.
Speed.
Oh, hey, watch that wire.
Hurry, please.
Ready. And action.
We did all we could.
Oh, God.
There's some insurance forms that we need you to fill out.
Well, I made a couple of calls. And we could have a new crew by Friday.
Why bother?
Why bother? Man, we're 10 yards from the finish line.
Maybe Natalie was right.
Natalie? About what?
It's all my fault.
Don't be ridiculous. Come on. Let's get you out of here.
Do you feel you can continue after this tragedy?
I have to. Of course I have to. To stop now would be an insult to Carl's memory. He would have wanted us to.
Do you feel like history is repeating itself?
What?
Do you feel like history is repeating itself?
What?
Okay, as probably you've already been told, there was an accident on this set a few days ago. It was very tragic, and we are still recuperating. But let me assure you that our insurance is paid and up to date for anybody having second thoughts. That's it, people. This one's for Carl.
Harry's doing better. Yeah. He's actually in somewhat of a good mood this morning. I just hope nothing, you know, happens today to piss him off. He's kind of teetering on the edge, you know what I mean?
Harry?
Oscar! You ready for your big finale?
Yeah, that's what I've been meaning to talk to you about.
What do you see the fake mold we made of your head?
Listen, the reason I wanted to talk to you is because, I'm leaving.
What?
I assure you it has nothing to do with what happened the other night.
Are you out of your mind? You can't leave.
I figured you'd be upset.
Upset? I've shot 90% of a movie with you. I give you a chance and this is how you repay me?
Well, couldn't you just get a stand-in? I mean, you got the fake head already.
The fake fucking head is supposed to match the actor it's removed from. What the hell's so damn important that you gotta leave now?
I got a part playing a detective in a pilot for a television series. It's my big break.
You signed a contract.
Look, this shoot was originally supposed to take what? 3 weeks? It's been almost 2 months.
Jay put you up to this, didn't he? It's a joke. Break the tension, you got me on camera.
It's no joke. I'm leaving. Here's my uniform.
Hey, don't fuck with me, pal. You ain't going anywhere. We got a movie to finish.
Correction. You got a movie to finish.
But you signed a contract!
Yeah. And in that contract, it said I would get paid. It never said anything about working in the middle of nowhere. Nothing to eat. No place to change. No place to even go to the bathroom like a human being.
Look, you read the script. You knew what you were in for.
It's freezing cold out here.
Oh, so that's my fault too?
No. It's your responsibility to look after your actor's well-being. I'm going. Good luck.
Don't go now, please. Just one more day. Come on, huh? Please? If you leave now, you're finished, you hear me? Maybe I should send some of your dailies to your new producer. See how long you keep your job. You're finished. You'll never work in this town again. Good.
Does anyone have a 20 on Harry?
I guess this is the film set?
You're looking at it. Oh, hey, Harry. Andy called. The killer's house is ready.
Hey, that's loaded.
On your fucking Jesus!
Holy shit! Harry!
What happened?
Harry blew his fucking head off.
Oh, my God!
One of those fucking guns was real?
Who's?
This fucking guy.
I don't know him. He's not an extra.
Oh, my God, are you okay? Well, who the fuck are you?
Well, I'm Ted. The agency sent me. Well, I'm supposed to report to Natalie.
Oh, he's a security guard.
Oh, right. We hired you because we're having some trouble with some of the local kids around here.
What kind of trouble?
Go back to fucking Hollywood!
Gotcha. What do you want me to do?
Shoot them!
Well, unless you feel physically threatened.
Oh, then just do whatever you can to stop them, huh?
Will do.
Are you all right? What are you thinking?
Uh, I've never done any acting before.
Nothing to it. Now remember, only shoot the back of his head. So, Ted, all we need you to do is to take the gun, aim it, fire, back up, and the killer will grab you and cut your head off.
Well, they're not really gonna chop my head off, are they?
Why, you got somewhere to be? Just kidding, we got a fake head, don't worry about it.
Hey, Harry, the insurance company needs you to sign off on Carl's burial costs.
Okay, people, pictures up.
Speed. And action. Cut. Great. Hanu, how was that?
Good. So, have you ever considered acting professionally?
No, not really.
Well, you should. You're a natural.
Oh, thank you.
Hey, man. I heard about Carl. It's fucked up.
Who? Carl? What's he do?
Knife?
Oh, Carl, yeah.
So, yeah, everything is pretty much finished.
This is a killer's house. Very creepy.
You guys want to go inside, check it out?
Oh, no. I want to wait till we're ready, get the full effect. Good job. Look tense. Okay, get to the door, really tense. You're tense now. You're nervous. It's the killer's house. Get ready to kick the door in. Cut! Andy, you're in the shot!
Okay, people, that's lunch.
So, now that you're almost finished, are you finally able to relax a little?
Oh, I can't relax until it's over. I'm sure the evil has one more surprise up its sleeve.
Yeah, but you got one more shot to go. What can go wrong?
This is the most difficult and problematic shoot of my life. I'm just a little afraid to let my guard down.
But remember your theory, how often difficult shoots result in great movies.
Maybe I'm being a little paranoid. We only have one more shot to go. Hey, you're right. What could go wrong?
Hey, wow, those look like real police cars. Way to go.
I didn't order any real police cars.
What? What the hell's going on?
Andy, what the hell's going on?
They wrecked everything. They destroyed everything. All my work.
Folks, hey, back up.
What's going
back
on?
Here?
Who's in charge here?
I am. Would somebody please tell me what's happening?
Why?
We're passing and damaging private property.
No, we have permission to be here. We have an agreement from the owner.
M&A Bank?
No. Jay. Tell him we have permission.
Oh, yeah, we have a signed location agreement with the owner of this house, Crenshaw.
He used to own this place. The bank foreclosed on him 2 years ago. We caught him a couple weeks back throwing rocks at the windows.
Hey, Jay, call someone, will you? Jay! Hey, you really have to take him in?
Hey, what's going on here? Oh, please call somebody.
Don't worry, Harry.
Call somebody.
I'll do the best
I
can.
Jay, you've got to do something about this.
Turn it off. Turn the camera off. Turn it off. Turn it off.
Harry! Harry!
We still get paid a full day, right?
What are you doing here?
Jay was afraid you'd beat him up if he came, so I agreed.
Thanks.
Listen, so I spoke to the bank, and they said that if you agree to repair the damages, they won't press charges.
Well, where's Jay?
In New Jersey.
New Jersey?
Yeah. When Ivan heard they weren't getting paid a full day, he stole the negative. He's holding it for ransom until Jay brings the cash.
Mercenaries.
Harry, you look terrible.
I've been doing a lot of thinking.
I think this is my last film. I'm gonna go to culinary school, get a job at Denny's. I think I can still be creative. You know, they got those little smiley face pancakes.
Harry, I was pissed off. I didn't mean those things I said.
Yes, you did, and you were right.
Look, you've just had a little bit of bad luck. You've gotta finish this film.
That's like having a heart attack in a tennis match and being accused of forfeiting.
Yeah, we're here. Yes, we got the cash. What floor are you on? All right, let's do this. Whoa, no, man, I'll handle this.
Who is it?
Who the fuck?
Well, where is it?
Nice try, buddy. Money first. Count it.
Count it?
Out loud.
20, 40, 60, 80, 100. 20, 40, 60, 80.
Plus gas and tolls.
Plus gas and tolls? Motherfucker, you Shanghai the film and you want us to fucking pay your gas and tolls? Fuck.
Money first.
Negative first.
Money first.
Negative first.
Money first.
Negative first.
Money.
Big fat fuck.
You never got your final shot.
You have no ending.
I was thinking about that. What if we left it ambiguous?
Do you even know what that word means? Okay, what?
Well, what if we don't know what happens to the killer? What if we leave our audience on the edge of their seats?
That's optimistic.
And just as we're about to reveal the ending, it just ends. Leaving everybody in suspense. Just end it before it actually ends. That's never been done before.
There's a reason for that.
What?
It's fucking stupid. I'm afraid to walk out during a screening. Now I gotta be afraid of people sticking around to the fucking end?
It is intriguing.
Yeah. That he's been able to survive this long with the brain of an armadillo.
Look, I am sorry about the house. How many times do I have to say it?
Suit yourself, Harry, but I think it could work.
You really think so?
Oh, if Natalie likes it, it must be good.
Okay, fine. You want to release a film with no ending. Might as well go down in flames. But just let me go on record that this is the stupidest idea I've ever heard.
Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? That's the ending? It's brilliant.
Really?
Yeah, the ending. It's so avant-garde. How did you come up with that?
Well, the film just kind of took on a life of its own. By the end, I didn't even feel like I was in control.
Well, I'm gonna call Mitch and Schwartzbaum. Mitch is gonna flip over this. You just made the A-list as far as I'm concerned.
And that shot of the girl's breast out of focus? I thought that was so tasteful. I mean, there's so much gratuitous nudity in films today, kids getting the wrong message. Mitchell, it's Terry. I'm sitting here with Harry Penderecki. No, I'm not going to run. I just watched his latest picture, and let me tell you, it's a masterpiece. Yes. 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 Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, they loved it.
Yeah, I'm sure we'll get an offer today, and I hear there's a bidding war going on, so it could get even better. I know. Well, I couldn't have done it without you. Yeah, I'll see you at the party. Bye. Hey, Barney.
Oh, LMB Productions. We have to talk.
Sure, what is it?
Harry, there was an accident here last night. One of the generators on the third floor, it exploded.
Third floor? The storage room?
Yeah, and I'm afraid that your negative was...
Oh my God, it's okay, right?
Well, I'm... The room is, it's gone. The room is gone. Now, Harry, it'll be all right. Look, I know how hard you worked at this, and look, you know, the insurance will cover all your costs, and or most of them anyway, but if there was anything I could do, if it's any consolation, I can just...
Oh, my God! Harry!
It's only the second floor.
What the fuck are you doing?
It's gone. It's all gone. It's finished.
Yeah, it's finished. I picked it up yesterday.
You pick what up?
The negative? They're doing the titles right now over at New Vision. Now get up before someone gives you a dollar.
So, is this vindication for all your hard work?
Oh, makes all the pain just melt away. It also helps that thanks to all the mind-altering drugs I took during the 80s, I have virtually no short-term memory left.
Thank you.
Hey, those are 15 bucks, pal.
Hi.
$8.70. This is only a dollar.
That's cool.
It's $8.70.
It's okay.
This is only...
It's okay.
It's not okay. You know, I've been meaning to ask you. LMB Productions. What does that stand for?
Oh, it's short for lick my balls. I figured, fuck them, you know? Thanks for coming.
Hey, you right-handed?
Yeah.
I don't want you touching my popcorn with the same hand you masturbate with. Now get me another bucket.
You believe this guy?
Mr. Penderecki?
Yes.
I'm your biggest fan.
Wonderful.
Your films have influenced my entire life.
Glad to hear that.
My favorite one is, Crazed Fan, about the kid who idolizes the famous movie director, and he shoots him, you know, to keep him perfect forever and ever, preserved in time! Boom! It's okay. It's a joke. These are blanks. I did this to prove a point that the media needs to be responsible for the messages that it's...
Ah! Fucking asshole.
Damn it, to hell.
Don't alone.